Okay, so good afternoon, everybody. Good afternoon, students from Financial Management course. Okay, so our topic for today is very essential for us because we're taking up Financial Management course, diba? So, as one of my forte and specialty, because I am a CFMP, Certified Financial Market Professional, and I am certified by the Philippine Exchange Commission, Stocks and Exchange Commission, to market international businesses and local businesses in terms of stocks and finances. So, students, before we started our discussion, first, let's go back with the meaning of IBT or internal businesses or international businesses. I mean, when we say international businesses, these are businesses that consist of transactions that are devised and carried out across national borders to satisfy our objective as individuals and company and the organizations. Okay, when we say international businesses, these are our transactions. Like, for example, selling of bonds, buying of bonds throughout across the Philippines or in the other countries, no? And one of the objective of this is to satisfy ourselves and to gain more profit for individual or group of people in the companies or exceptional organizations. Next, the economic system also for international businesses is exchanging goods and services, which is currently conducted between individuals or group of businesses in many countries or in multiple countries. For example, no, I am selling, for example, a petroleum. So, as a petroleum seller or owner, I have to market my goods, no, into the other countries. That's why I have to join other system and, you know, their associations in order for me to have lots of buyers, diba? Then, international business also tackles about the entities, multinational corporation, international business companies that is mostly engaged between multiple countries. Next, the need for international businesses. First is the cost flows of ideas and services, and also capital across the world. So, in international business, what we're talking about is all about the exchanging of goods and services. It's all about the import, export, export system of our country and, of course, the other country. Okay, so ito ha. Bakit nga ba nagkakaroon ng tinatawag na nating location association throughout the world? Diba? So, bakit nga ba yung mga countries, they have their association, like for example, Southeast Asian nation, like halimbawa Americans, so we have the NAFTA in America, so we also have the European, so bakit nga ba may ganito? Ang purpose nito ay para mapadali yung ating pagbebentahan, diba? Para mapadalo yung transportation of goods and services ng bawat bansa. Okay, next. Facilitate the mobility of labor, capital, and technology. We also provide the challenging employment opportunity to each and everybody. Diba? The more that we encourage people to invest in our homeland, the more na maraming trabaho na maraming trabaho. So, it will benefit the nation, not only the people who is engaged in businesses, but also the people around the community, di ba? So, makaka-create ng maraming trabaho, magiging profitable, at isa pa, makakatulong siya sa ating economy. Next is Next is to relocate resources and make preferential choices and shift activities to global level. So what is this? So the more that we do business internationally, no? Marami tayong mga activities na pwedeng ma-engage doon sa ating businesses. 'Di ba? Marami tayong pwedeng tawag dito, not only the activities. Marami tayong pwedeng resources na pwedeng maisali sa ating businesses na one of the preferential choice ng ibang countries kasi need din nila or domestically need nila, internationally need pala nila, sorry. Next natin. Okay, so sa licensing tayo. Licensing. Okay, when we say licensing, this is a business agreement in which company give another company the permission to manufacture its product or for a specified payment. So, pag sinabi natin licensing, no, ginagamit natin yung pangalan ng other company or yung mother company na binilihan natin or binilihan natin ng kanyang franchise name, for example, ganun. Para makapagbenta tayo ng produkto nila. There are a few faster and more profitable ways to grow business than licensing patents. Like trademarks, copyright, design, and other intellectual property to others. Okay? So, sa licensing din, no? Pwede tayong magbenta ng product ng isang business or manufacturer gamit yung kanilang trademarks, copyrights, design, and other intellectual property rights, no? Kapag tayo ay tawag dito, kapag tayo ay may licensing agreement between that company, pwede na nating ibenta yung product nila. For example, about 90% of $160 million a year in sales of Calvin Klein Incorporated came from licensing. The designer name to makers of undergarments, jeans and perfumes. So, yan yung pinaka one of the example, no? Sa Calvin Klein. So, Calvin Klein is a company. And then, ginagamit ng mga designer nila, ginagamit nila yung mga ginawa ng mga designer nila to income or to generate income. Diba? Next, we have the management contract. Okay, when we say management contract, these are agreements between the investor and the owner of a project and a project management company. Hard for coordinating and overseeing a contract. So, sa management contract, ito na yung kontrata. Or this is the black and white paper agreement between two companies or maybe company or the owner. So, it specify the following conditions, durations, and agreements, and method of computing management fees. So, ito ay kontrata, at hindi lang siya basta-basta kontrata. Ito ay ebidensya na kayo ay partners, di ba? Limbawa, no, gagawa kayo ng business, dapat may kontra kayo para meron kayong hahabulin, no, doon sa owner at saka sa mga nag-i-invest. It is an agreement by which the company will provide its organizational and management expertise in form of services. So, kadalasan, kapag meron tayong management contract, it is in form, kaya ka gumagawa ng contract eh, no? Kaya nga sinabing management contract, it is in form of service. So, hindi siya in form of goods kasi hindi naman ang agreement is all about goods. Ang agreement is all about service. It's all about specialization and expertise. And then we have FDI and FII. When we say FDI, this stands for foreign direct investment. Highlight ko. Okay, when we say foreign direct investment, these are direct investment from national financial account. Or when we say foreign direct investment, these are investment from foreign asset into domestic structure, equipment, and organization. Typically, it includes the stock market, the foreign direct market, and the most useful to a country investment is the equity of the company, because the equity investment are potential. It is a hot money in which we can leave the first sign of trouble, whereas FDI is durable, generally whether things go well or badly. Okay, so para maintindihan nyo tong FDI na to, by the end of the topic, I will be sending you the Bloomberg forecast. And then, ituturo ko sa inyo doon kung paano yung trading, kung paano yung pagbenta, paano yung pag-sold, paano yung pag-read ng tawag dito ng stock market, at kung ano yung FDI at saka FII. Paano yung equity analysis, kung paano natin i-analyze yung capital ng isang negosyo, tapos dun tayo mag-i-invest. So, soon, after neto, ituturo ko sa inyo ang paano. So, sa meaning muna tayo. So, ito yung direct investment ng mga company. So, saan ba ito makikita? Nakikita to sa Bloomberg, no? Internationally, we can see the financial status of the business sa Bloomberg. So, makikita mo dun yung equity nila at kung paano mo siya i-forecast at paano mo malalaman yung analysis niya. Sabi nga dito, very, very durable daw yung FDI o yung equity analysis, kasi dun mo makikita kung bumabagsak ba yung negosyo o hindi. Dun mo rin makikita kung okay ba mag-invest, no? Kung ikaw ay financial market professional sooner or later, kung okay ba mag-invest dun sa business na yon o hindi. Kung may potential ba siya o wala. And then next, we have the FIIs. In this term, this is most commonly in India. This refers us to the outside company investing in financial market of India. International institutional investor must consider the register of SEC or Security of Exchange Board of India to participate in the market. And one of the major market regulation pertaining FII involves placing limit of FII ownership in India company. Okay, so FII, hindi to ano sa atin, para sa India lang to. Because hindi sila kasi pwedeng mag-direct invest nang hindi sila nakakapag register sa SEC nila. Hindi sila pwedeng makapag-participate through international market kapag hindi sila hindi sila nakakapag-register sa Securities and Exchange Commission nila. Meron din tayo nito dito sa Philippines, no? Meron din tayong FII regulations dito sa Philippines. But because here in the Philippines, we have lots of international businesses which is already operating here in the Philippines. So hindi na natin in-exercise tong tiyatawag nating market regulations na to. So, ano na tayo? Next, we have the international investment and trades. Okay, when we say international investment and trades, developed countries are active players of this II investment, or approximately 80% of the global investment emanate rich countries. For example, FDIs in US stands for $600 billion, while US FDI is almost $800 billion. The developed and developing countries are the major recipient of FDI. So sa FDI naman, kadalasan ng mga pausbong na country pa lang, yung mga mahihirap na countries like Southeast Asia, sila yung mga major recipient, o sila yung mga major component ng FDI. Sila yung makasama dyan sa FDI na yan. Meron naman tayong mga reasons for internationalizations. Sabi, one of the reason is, there is lot of money in overseas market. Totoo naman yun, no? Mas marami ang kinikita kapag ine-export mo yung produkto mo. The eminency from the trading or triad from US, Europe, and Japan have a huge asset in quarter of these assets are found in foreign markets. The GE, or global expenditure of US, is one of the top MNC with asset of over 300 million. Shaney, 300 million, 300 billion in 1997. And nearly third its asset were found in overseas country. The Dutch UK firm Shells has huge asset and 3/5 of these are located overseas. So, one of the reason is para kumita ng marami. No? So, hindi ko na dyan generalize ko na. Hindi ko na siya inisa-isa pa, no? Sabi nga rito, katulad ng US, Europe, no? Because they are one of the top leading tawag dito, exporter in the country. Next, it is being realized that domestic markets are no longer adequate and rich. Like Japan, flooded American with automobile electronics because domestic market was not large enough to absorb whatever was the product. So, one of the example is Japan, no? So, in-export nila yung kanilang product kasi they believe that when they export their product, they can, you know, benefit and gain lots of money from it, no? Tama nga naman, kapag ikaw, nag-export ka ng product mo, marami ka naman talagang benepisyong matatanggap. Magigain ka naman talaga ng malaking benefit. It is just because most of the countries are earning because of, you know, export product. Example, no, yung dito sa Pilipinas na lang, no, yung mga in-export natin na bananas, na mangoes in the other countries, mas malaki kinikita natin doon. Alam niyo kung bakit? Kasi ang bentahan doon, dollars eh. Pero pag dito ka, sa Pilipinas nagbenta, domestic, syempre, ang pera na currency na ginagamit niyo is Philippine money. Yung earnings ay hindi ganon kaganda. Hindi ganon kalaki. Pag i-compare mo siya sa ibang bansa or international ka magbebenta, syempre, mas malaki yung kikitain mo. Next, company often set overseas plan to reduce high transportation costs and the higher ratio of unit cost from selling the price unit and the more significant transportation become a factor. So, ito yung isa rin sa mga strategy to, no? Halimbawa, ikaw ay nagbebenta ng textile. So, instead na gagawin mo doon sa home country mo yung textile, tapos itra-transport mo, one of the best way is for you to put up the business doon mismo sa pagbebentahan mo. Alam niyo kung bakit? Ang unang nare-reduce is yung high transportation. Kasi pwedeng isakay yan sa barko, sasakay mo yan sa aeroplano, mas mahal yung gagastusin. At pag mas mahal yung ginasto, syempre, yung unit cost ng selling price ng per unit ng product mo is mas malaki din. Next, the motivation to global and high-tech industries is slightly different. They spend lots on research, development for new products, domestic sales, export, to generate sufficient cash flow. The company naturally might look for overseas manufacturing plants and sales branches to generate higher sales and better cash flow. So, one of the strategy din, halimbawa ako ay, ako ang may-ari ng iPhone company, is for me to find manpower outside my country. Kasi halimbawa ako, iPhone, diba, ang mother home ng iPhone is United States. Kapag doon ako gumawa ng factory, syempre, mas mahal yung per hour ng mga tao doon. So, mas mamahal yung telepono ko. Hindi siya magiging affordable. Hindi siya magiging saleable. So, what I will do is aangkat ako ng parts ng cellphone ko sa iba-ibang lugar. No? Bawa, pwedeng sa Thailand, pwedeng sa Philippines, no? Sa Philippines, pwede ditong gawin yung dito ginagawa sa iPhone. Dito ginagawa yung kanilang screen, LCD screen. Yung kanilang IC ginagawa sa Taiwan. Yung kanilang back cover ginagawa sa China. Tapos, ina-assemble sa Amerika. Okay? So, ang daming pinagdaanan, no? Ang daming lugar. It is just because I wanted to, you know, to profit more. Bakit profit more? Dito sa mga bansa na to, sa mga nasabi kong bansa, mura lang yung kanilang per hour rate, yung manpower. And dahil mura lang yung manpower nila at masisipag yung mga tao dito, the company has the ability and the company has the potential to gain more. No? Pwedeng pakyawan yung gawa nila. At pag pakyawan yun, so maramihan yun, no? Maraming magagawa na phone, maraming kikitain yung company. So, that's one of the best strategy. Next, firm go global to access resources that are unavailable or more expensive at home. Like Japan, the largest paper company Nippon Sheshi, needs to do more import wood pulp. Its own huge forests are processing facilities in Australia, Canada, and US. Another reason is the labor market also attract company to international businesses. One way for a company to gain competitive advantage is by locating production facilities in low-cost country. Ito yung sinasabi ko sa inyo, no? Another example, no, kanina, no? Alam niyo ba yung Victoria's Secret? Victoria's Secret Company is a branded lingerie in United States. Pero hindi niyo ba alam na dito sa Cebu ginagawa ang Victoria's Secret? Okay, so hindi niyo yan alam. Bakit dito sa Cebu ginagawa yung Victoria's Secret ng mga lingerie? Kasi dito sa Pilipinas, mas mababa yung per hour ng mga manggagawa compared kung magtatayo sila ng negosyo sa Amerika mismo. Pero ina-assemble yon at nilalagyan ng tags sa ibang bansa na. Diba? Another example, no? Hindi niyo ba alam na dito rin sa Pilipinas, ginagawa yung mga mamahaling bags. Hindi naman lahat, ano? Ano bang bag yun? Swish bag. Okay? Yung swish bag na binibenta somewhere in the Middle East, no? Dito yun sa Pilipinas gawa. Bakit dito sa Pilipinas gawa? Kasi dito, mura yung labor compared mo dun sa Middle East. Parang ganon. Next, firms go global to avoid protectionist barriers imposed by local government. Government erect various from barriers to entry in their domestic market by foreign firm. Company enter foreign market because of competitor and have already done it. Government throughout the world offer variety of incentive to attract MNCs. Okay, so yung gobyerno sa buong mundo, one of their strategy is to attract people to invest in their home country. Kasi the more investment, the more jobs, di ba? So we have the international versus domestic businesses. We have the basis, which is international business and domestic business. Payment, mostly foreign currency, tulad ng sinasabi ko sa inyo. But for domestic business, syempre, local currency. Rules, subject to international law and regulation. For domestic naman, national rules. Custom and tradition, you have different custom and tradition. So, kung ikaw ay exporter, no, hindi ka pwede mag-export ng mga brand mo kapag hindi mo alam yung customs and tradition nila. And then, we have the domestic same custom and tradition. Example, before, no, my dad had, we had our own factory. And one of our product is Nipa wine. So, we are selling our product outside the country. Exporter kami. So, we are selling our product outside the country. And one of the country is Brunei. Kasi, tanggap siya ng halal. Kaya, one of the country is Brunei, Singapore, no? India. We export in India also. And mas maganda yung kitaan. Pero before you export or market your product, see to it that the custom and tradition is fitted for your product. And then we have same custom and tradition just like Philippines, di ba? We are open also for that kind of product, yung mga Nipa wines, di ba? Because we are tropical country and we like that. Hindi katulad niyan na kapag halimbawa ako ay mag-export ng Nipa wine sa Latin America, ano, hindi naman sila umiinom ng mga Nipa or something. Syempre, hindi siya tawag dito, hindi siya tanggap na sikmura ng mga tao doon. Di ba? Next, we have legal and economic system has to face different legal economics and tax rate system. So, bawat country, iba yung tax rate nila. And when you sell domestically, it is almost the same. And then, it has to follow geoentric approach for international standard. Pero pag dito naman, ganun pa din. Next, globalization refers to shift towards a more integrated and independent world economy. So, globalization has several facets, including globalization of market, globalization of production, and so on. Globalization of market refers to merging of historically distinct and separate national market into huge global market. Falling barriers to cross-border trades have made easier to sell internationally. So, sa globalization, ni-unite niya yung mga sellers domestically and they go forward with international selling. It has urged that sometimes the taste of and preferences of customer is different in different nations are beginning to converge in some global norms, thereby helping to create a global market. One of the example for this is yung samyupsal natin. No? So, dati sa kanila, sa Korea, domestic lang ang pagbebenta ng samyupsal because this is their own traditional food. But because they joined global marketplace, they conjoined international culinary for culinary markets for food outside their country. Kaya nakarating yan dito sa Pilipinas. Hindi lang sa Pilipinas, no? Merong samyupsal sa Malaysia, Singapore, America, di ba? Another example. Coca-Cola soft drinks, di ba? International siya. Sony PlayStation, video game. McDonald's hamburger. We also have McDonald's hamburger. And Jollibee, di ba? So, talon tayo. Okay. Next, we have globalization of production. Globalization of production refers to the sourcing of goods and service from location around the globe to take advantage of the national difference in cost, quality factor production by doing the companies hope to lower overall cost structure to improve quality, functionality of their product offering, thereby allowing them to compete effectively. Diba? Example ko nga sa inyo, no? Ang iPhone. Ang mga parts ng iPhone ay ginagawa sa iba-ibang lugar. yung memory niya, yung lahat-lahat, yung LCD niya, yung kanyang charger and everything. Iba-ibang lugar. Meron sa Pilipinas, meron sa Taiwan, meron sa Thailand, sa South Korea. At ang assembly part niya ay, syempre, Amerika. Diba? Bakit ba ginagawa to? Para mas mapababa yung cost ng mga kumpanya na nagne-negosyo. Mas mapababa yung cost nila, pero mas mapapataas yung kanilang tinatawag nating profit. Another example is IBM ThinkPad X31 laptop computer. The IBM is from America, pero yung kanilang keyboard, hard drive, made in Thailand. Memory nila is from Korea. Built wireless card nila, Malaysia. Processor nila, US. Diba? Iba-iba. Para nga mapababa at syempre, kumita pa sila. So, hanggang dito na lang yung ating pag-aaralan. We will continue our discussion for emergence of global institution by next week. See you guys. Thank you for listening. Guys, I hope that, na makikipag-cooperate kayo. Magsisend ako sa inyo ng Google link. And then, you're going to check whether you are included in my class record for confirmation at saka rechecking bago ko isubmit yung grade ninyo. Okay, thank you and see you again next week. See you again next week.